Alright guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a look at the MAC-10 SMG. In my opinion, still one of the best SMGs in the game, especially if you want to pair it up with a sniper. It's actually pretty solid. So we're going to be go ahead and we're going to be trying to make the fastest kill in MAC-10, but we're also going to make it a little bit mobile. So we're going to have a few speed attachments on here as well. And yeah, let's just jump straight into it. Alright, so for the first attachment, we're going to be using the Agency Suppressor. This is going to give you sound suppression, vertical recoil control, muzzle velocity, as well as extended damage range. Now, usually if I was pairing this gun up with an assault rifle or something that I'm going to be playing fast paced and aggressive with, I would use the sound moderator because you get a little bit of ADS speed. But because I'm pairing it up with a sniper in this video, definitely want that little bit of extra range, so the Agency Suppressor is definitely going to be the choice. For the second attachment, we're going to want the 5.9 Task Force Barrel. This is going to give us effective damage range, muzzle velocity, and also strafe speed. This does hurt your horizontal and vertical recoil control, but honestly, the difference isn't really that noticeable, so this is definitely an attachment you're going to want to run. It's going to help you win those gunfights up close because of the strafe speed, and also take out enemies a little bit further away because of that muzzle velocity and that extended damage range. So for the grip, we're going to take a look at the Striker grip. This is going to give you increased movement speed as well as hip fire accuracy, making those close quarter gunfights a lot easier because, number one, you can be a little more nimble and you can be a little more agile and, you know, finesse people because of the movement speed. But also the hip fire accuracy with this grip is actually pretty good. Because we're not going to be running a laser sight on this gun. So this little bit of hipfire accuracy actually really does go a long way when you're actually clearing out a building or someone catches you off guard close range. You just got to get a quick hipfire off. This grip is definitely the best. Okay, so speaking of lasers, we're going to be running the Tiger Team Spotlight Barrel. This increases your movement speed once again and also gives you aim walking movement speed. This is also going to pair up nice with the strafe speed of the Task Force Barrel, making you an absolute nightmare close range because, like I said, you're going to be so quick. It's also really good for rotating as well. If you try to rotate from zone to zone, it's going to be absolutely perfect because you're going to be able to, you know, be in the open way less because you're moving so quick. Obviously the only downside to this is the flashlight is visible to enemies, so in close quarters you're probably going to want to ADS walk just so it hides the Tiger Team spotlight. But yeah, definitely one of the greatest attachments for the Mac, and I would definitely give it a go. So for the fifth and final attachment, we're going to be running this Stanag 53-round drum. I don't believe there's a very big difference in the fast mag. I know with the fast mag, you do lose ADS speed, but the difference in reload speed is like not even measurable at all. So Stanag 53-round drum, you're not going to get as big of an ADS reduction, and you're also going to get similar, pretty much the same reload speed. This is going to help you clear out, you know, 2-3 enemies with one clip, and pairing it up with all the speed attachments that we have on this gun, you know, Task Force Barrel, Tiger Team Spotlight, as well as the Striker grip, you're going to be an absolute just monster up close, and you're going to be so quick that people won't even be able to track you. So with that being said, let's just jump right into the video. In today's video, I'm pairing it up with the Carnin 8K. And here's the class setup for anybody who wants it. But yeah, it's my Mimo. See ya. It feels so unnatural to run auto attack sprint. fact that I almost died there, bro. I had to play that so weird because I wasn't getting any aim assist through the banister. Nice gun, bro. Sometimes I can be a fucking moan, but I don't mean to be. The only reason I complain about this game is because I love COD. Like, I've been playing COD since I was 7 years of age, man, you know? So whenever I see big changes to COD that negatively affect players who've been playing it for all this time, that's when I get pissed off. His name was not a hacker. Heartbeat sensors are fucking stupid. They really are. I don't know how you use Glacier anymore. You know, when you have 60 days played on the game, you have to open yourself up to all playstyles, man. Or else the game gets boring very, very fast. He's up there. That's where I want to be, up there. You reckon I could just go up and get him? Fuck it. Fuck it, bro. So yeah, if I ever complain about the game, because I love it. I just want it to be better.
I'm coming to get you.
I'm actually cheating. Level 12. NW2 and Ghosts? Oh, Ghosts was fucking terrible. Ghosts was like this game. Ghosts was a game that was literally made for granddads. Just like this game. I've played my fair share of Ghosts. I was top 800 in the world for free-for-all in that game. At one stage. For PlayStation. Top 800 in the world. For FFA. But that's also because I love COD, though. That's not because the game was good. Remember Advanced Warfare? Yeah, that game was really fucking good. That was the only game in COD. Well, yeah, I would say that's probably the game that you could shit on someone so bad if you were good at the game. Like, if you were a good COD player, bro, and you, like, took the time to get good at, like, really good at Advanced Warfare, you really got rewarded for it because the game skill gap was so big. You needed so much, like, you needed good movement, you needed good gun skill. Like, that game, the skill gap on that game was by far the biggest, and that's why I loved it personally. I know people don't like it because they don't like advanced movement cards, and they also don't like supply drops, but in my personal opinion, I think advanced movement card is better. That's just me though. I understand why people like boots on the ground. I can't understand it, but in my opinion, I feel like advanced movement cards, number one, they're way less campy, so no one really camps. And number two, you actually get rewarded for being good. Bro, I can't hit this guy to save my life. The advanced movement cards are better, but I love them. Opinions on Cold War? Cold War could be really, really good. Could be. But the kill streak system. The kill streak system on Cold War. The lack of weapon balancing. And the spawn system, in my opinion, those three things, the spawn system, the streak system, and the lack of gun balance in that game, completely ruined it for me. Like, light machine guns are way too strong. The spawns flip way too often. And to top it all off, you don't even get rewarded, really, for playing well. You go on, like, a 13 kill streak, man, you get a fucking war machine. Like, what? And then you have to wait for another 10 years to get it back. Because there's a fucking delay. You know? But at the same time, you shouldn't make the slow playstyle and the campy playstyle the best. Like, you shouldn't make it the most, like... Like, there's no point to rush in this game. Like, there's no point to rush in Modern Warfare. Even on multiplayer, there's no point to rush, because you get rewarded way too much for camping on this game. See, Blackout had a big skill gap, but it also had a lot of things to help new players, because the skill gap in Blackout is actually pretty big, but it still had a lot of stuff in the game for new players. I only got it when it was free to play. Yeah, Blackout's so good, bro. Honestly, Blackout is really good. Enemy UAV overhead. Like I said, there's still a lot in the game to help new players, like the equipment and stuff. You just play solos, pretty much. Your sniping is so good, it's because it's so easy. On this game, it's literally point and click. There's no skill at all. Plus, you get aim assist as well when you're sniping. big rotations. Big boy rotations. Look at this shit.
Lone Wolf calling Wolf Den, over.
This is Striker 3-1, good copy. Strike inbound. No hits on that run.
Oh my god, nice leg, what the fuck?